feed thee every hour. I don't know what the next moment of this day is going to bring, but most gracious God, no tender voice like that can peace afford. I need thee, oh, I need thee every hour. Oh, bless me now, my Savior. But I want you to know, you don't need him. You don't need him in those moments when nobody else is there. You don't need him in those moments when you don't know whether you got a job or not. You don't need him in those moments whether you don't know if you have a spouse or not. You don't need him in those moments whether you're in the middle of the night or if you're in the middle of a storm. There will be some moments when you're going to need him. And can I tell you, God is ready, willing, and able to help you in your time of trouble. Glory to God. He's willing, y'all. There's some people who can help you, but they ain't willing. There are some people who have the ability to help you go through this, but they're not willing. But don't you be discouraged. You serve a God. That's all right, baby. You don't have to help me. That's all right. You don't have to do it. It's okay. I got one walking with me. I got one talking with me. Hallelujah. When the storm clouds are rising, oh God, I'm so glad I got shelter. Hallelujah. Yeah. The very present helper. Hallelujah. In the time of trouble. Can you tell somebody around you, God is always present?
God is always present
in your low place. Yeah. He's present when you can't find a friend.
Yeah.
God is present and he knows how to preserve you. He knows how to tuck you away. When the enemy comes to destroy, when the enemy comes to distract, when the enemy comes to make you feel like you are defeated, can you look at somebody in the eye and say, my God, my God, he's always with me. Sometimes your storm is pushing you to a place of greater. Sometimes the storm that you're in is pushing you to a place faster than you would get there without the wind. Faster than you would get there without the water.
Yeah.
And you got to be comfortable going through, because that Bible tells us that many of the afflictions of the righteous. How many of you know in this life you will have some storms? In this life you're going to have some moments of defeat. You're going to have some moments when it feels like the hell that you're going through is because of something you did, some seed you sown. But not all the time is hell considered to be something wrong. Sometimes God allows hell so that he can make you bigger. Sometimes he allows hell so that he can use what the devil meant for evil to make it work out for your good. I told you last week that something good is coming out of what? This. And don't you dare be discouraged. Don't you dare be defeated. Don't you dare feel like God is not with you, because he's yet present. Because there is power of life and death in your tongue. So what you speak is what you shall see. What you say is what will shape the very world that you're in. So that's why you must stand and say, in my weakness, I am strong. In my moments when it feels like I'm defeated, I stand in victory to say, we have the what? Victory. But how many of you know all you had to do was get up in the morning and everything looked different? Can I tell you that even in your worst season, all you got to do is keep getting up in the morning? Somebody said, morning by morning, brand new mercies I would see. And if you can wake up in the morning, he said, I'll give you new mercies. If you can wake up in the morning, he said, I'll give you joy. Somebody said, unspeakable joy. Some stuff you can't blame on the devil if you did it. Some stuff you can't blame on the devil if you orchestrated it. And you got to go on through that season and know that trouble don't last what? Always. Hallelujah. He's my covering. He's my protector. He's standing between you and it. He's standing between you and the demonic forces that have come to disrupt, that have come to hinder. God is our protector. And not only is he's a guard that stands by. Oh, glory to God. I said he's a guard standing by. Your situation may shake you, but it won't shake God. He's a rooftop that didn't get leaks. He's a rooftop that doesn't cave in. He's a rooftop that the wind can blow. financial stability. And I'm sure that I'll tell you, he's not after your mind. But at the end of the day, on a daily basis, when he comes to disrupt and distract, there is one thing that the saints must hold on to, and that is God is yet present. You must understand that in his presence, there is fullness of joy. Bible says it like this, to him that believe, out of your belly shall rivers flow. And I'm telling you, if you are a believer, there's a river flowing on the inside of you. It hurts, but pull up from your river. I know you're sick right now, but there's a river on the inside of you flowing. I don't feel my joy yet, but I'll leap for it. I don't see my joy yet, but I'll leap for it. I can't feel joy yet, but I'll leap for it. Everything you're going through is not for them. Some of the stuff you're going through is to get rid of them. Oh!